Harissa, olive oil, garlic, salt and pepper, preserved lemon and cumin powder and parsley are mixed together. Infused saffron water is also added and the chicken is then immersed in this marinade. This will be cooked in a tagine. This pot helps to trap and circulate moisture, allowing the flavors to develop and infuse into the food. Onion is sautéed in spices and the chicken is added on top with the marinade and covered with the tagine lid. Once the chicken is cooked, beans and olives as well as preserved lemon is added and this is cooked a little bit longer before serving. Welcome back to Kravings Food Adventures. Today I'm going to be making a very authentic Moroccan dish. We're going to be making a chicken tagine. Now, if you don't have a tagine, you can also use a regular pot. However, if you do have a tagine, it cooks so beautifully because the steam just goes up to the top and the chicken turns out really moist and really flavorful. I'm going to be using some unique elements as well in this recipe that's going to make it absolutely delicious. Before I go any further this recipe, do make sure to subscribe to my channel and make sure to ring that bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Now, let's get cooking. Let's start with the preserved lemon. Typically, you can buy these bottled. These lemons have very thin skins and are quite small in size. I will also be using harissa or chili paste. If you can't find harissa, you can make it yourself. I have a recipe on my channel. I'm also going to be using saffron. This is Turkish saffron I bought back from Istanbul a few years ago. The saffron is a lot milder compared to Spanish saffron that I typically use in my Indian cooking. I will be cutting two of these small lemons. I'm going to scrape the pulp away from the skin and we're going to be using both separately. I will add a large pinch of saffron to a mug and I'm going to cover it with half a cup of hot water and I'm going to allow the saffron to steep. To make the marinade, I will add 2 tablespoons of harissa, 2 tablespoons of olive oil, 2 tablespoons of minced garlic, 1 tablespoon of salt, 1 tablespoon of pepper, and the reserved pulp of the lemon. This is about 2 tablespoons. Next, I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of garlic powder, 1 tablespoon of cumin powder, and half a cup of chopped parsley. Mix this well together. Once the saffron water has had a chance to cool, I'm going to add this in as well. Now I'm going to add the chicken. I have 6 chicken thighs here. This is about 2 pounds and I'm using chicken bone-in thigh. You can also use breast or boneless if you like. I like to use dark meat as it's more succulent and the bone will help flavor the gravy. Make sure to flip the chicken over so it marinates on both sides. Now I'm going to add oil to the bottom of my tagine and I'm going to add half a cup of chopped onion. I'm also going to add 1 tablespoon of garlic powder, 1 tablespoon of paprika and 1 tablespoon of cumin powder and I'm going to mix this in with the onion. When you use your tagine, you must make sure to use a diffuser over direct heat so it's not touching the flame and it won't crack. I'm going to allow the tagine to heat up and then I'm going to put the lid on and allow this to cook for 10 to 15 minutes. Once the onion has cooked, I'm going to add the chicken as well as all of the marinade. This chicken is going to need to cook for about 45 to 60 minutes. Check it in between. Now that the chicken is cooked, I'm going to add 1 cup of mixed beans. And I'm going to throw in about 6 to 8 olives, as well as the reserved skins of the preserved lemons. I'm going to cover this and cook this for another 10 minutes, and then it's ready to serve. Enjoy.
Thank you so much for joining me on Cravings Food Adventures. I hope you enjoyed this delicious recipe for chicken tagine. It's such a unique recipe and super delicious. If you love my videos, guys, give me a thumbs up, leave me a comment below, and don't forget, make sure that you subscribe to my channel. This is the most important thing. I'm trying to hit 100,000 subscribers, and you can really help me get there. Also, make sure that you've rung the bell so you're notified the minute I upload a new video. And be sure to follow me behind the scenes on all of my other social channels. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, Twitter, and TikTok. Until I see you next time, do take care. Happy eating. Bye.